Fellow scientist Justin here. Sorry, running laps, maybe. Whoo! Whoo! So, today we're gonna hang on. Whoo! Sorry about that. I needed to take a minute to catch my breath.
Do you ever get winded while you're exercising? At times like these make me wonder, what is my body doing with all that breath anyway?
By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe the main functions of the respiratory and circulatory systems and identify their key parts. Let's get into it.
Whether you're using it to fog up a window, fill a theater with an operatic melody, or recover after running laps around a studio, breathing is key to how our bodies function. The respiratory system is the body system responsible for breathing. Remember, body systems are made up of organs working together to accomplish complex tasks. What organs do you think are part of the respiratory system? Take a breath and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Well, let's start at the beginning. There are two openings through which our bodies can take in air. Our mouths, and to the lament of anyone with a cold, our noses. Those openings meet at the throat, called the pharynx. From there, air can move down to the windpipe, or trachea, and into our lungs, the central organs of the respiratory system. There's one more key part of the respiratory system, though. It's called the diaphragm, and it's a muscle that sits just below the lungs. But air doesn't travel to the diaphragm like the rest of the respiratory system, so how does it help us breathe? Let's see if we can figure it out by examining the process of breathing firsthand. If it's comfortable for you, place one or two hands on your abdomen, that's just above your belly button. Breathe in and out. Deep breath in and out. Oh, right, the lesson. Scientists, as you breathe in deeply, pay close attention to what you feel happening in your abdomen. And in. Ah, as you are breathing in, or inhaling, could you feel your chest expanding? That motion is thanks to our friend, the diaphragm. The muscles of the diaphragm contract, pulling on the lungs and causing them to expand. This motion pulls air in to fill the space that was created. Then, when you exhale or breathe out, the diaphragm releases, compressing the lungs and pushing the air out. See for yourself. Try to blow out air while keeping your lungs expanded. It's a lot harder, right? Go back to normal breathing. Ooh, that's a lot better. So, the air goes in. The air goes out, done. Except all the cells in our bodies need the oxygen from the air. So how does that oxygen get from the lungs to all the other parts of the body? To find the answer, I want you to join me for another little exercise. All right, I am all ready. If it's comfortable for you, join me while I do some jumping jacks, or you can do whatever quick exercise works for you. As you exercise, pay attention to what happens to your body. Ready? Okay. One, two, three, four, five. Woo! Oh, that was a good workout. Don't worry, I promise there was a scientific reason we just did that. After those jumping jacks, I'm breathing
a lot harder. But that's not the only thing I observed. Did you notice any other changes in your body? Record your observations in your guided notes. If you're anything like me, those jumping jacks not only made your breathing heavier, but it also got your heart beating faster. You can actually feel your heart rate, or how quickly your heart is beating, by placing two fingers right here on the side of your throat, under your jaw. So when my body was working hard, my breathing got heavier and my heart rate got faster. So how do you think the oxygen collected by the respiratory system is moved throughout the body? If you said through your blood, you'd be correct. The circulatory system is the body system that circulates or moves blood throughout the body. At the heart of the circulatory system is, well, the heart. The heart is a muscle that acts as a pump. The muscles of the heart contract and relax, pushing blood all throughout your body. Blood is carried by tubes called blood vessels. There are two main types of blood vessels, arteries and veins. Arteries move blood away from the heart, and veins bring the blood back to the heart. I like to remember the difference by thinking A for artery means A for away. Blood is like the delivery driver of the body, bringing the substances our cells need where they need to go. But it has to pick up its cargo first. What does every cell need to function? Right, oxygen. When you inhale, your lungs load up with oxygen-filled air. Blood vessels in your lungs pick up that oxygen, transporting it to your heart. Your heart can then pump that oxygen-rich blood throughout the rest of your body. As your cells use the oxygen to complete their specialized functions, carbon dioxide is created as a waste product. Your blood also picks up the waste and carries it back to the lungs to be exhaled. It's like if your delivery driver also came back for the empty boxes. As we saw after those jumping jacks, the respiratory and circulatory systems work seamlessly together to deliver oxygen to our cells and remove waste products. When your body needs more fuel to function, like during high energy activities, both systems speed up and work a little harder. And when your cells are taking it a bit easier, like when you're asleep, both your breathing and your heart rate can slow down. Let's slow it down ourselves by reviewing everything we've learned today. The respiratory system is responsible for breathing. It's made up of the mouth, nose, pharynx, trachea, lungs, and diaphragm. The circulatory system is responsible for moving blood through the body. It's made up of the heart and blood vessels, like arteries and veins. Both systems work closely together to deliver oxygen to our cells and remove carbon dioxide. So, I realized I got winded running laps earlier because my body was using oxygen faster than my respiratory and circulatory systems could absorb it. And you know the best way to improve my oxygen absorption? Keeping up with a regular training schedule. And that means I gotta run. Remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time!